They are skimpful.
Hello, art family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. This week I wanted to talk about using oil paint in a sketchbook, in this case a Moleskine sketchbook. I'm going to start by talking about the tools that you'll need, but if you're only interested in the demo, that starts at a minute 40. So you don't need too much to get started with oil paint. It is a little bit expensive, but you need a gesso to put down on a hardboard or a page of your sketchbook, and then a cheap brush to apply it with. I use Gamsol or mineral spirits because I have kids and I don't really want to leave open terpenoid around the house. When working in a sketchbook, I like to use a fast drying medium like Liquin. You mix that into the paint and it'll dry quickly, and a cup for that to go into. You'll also need a little bin for your brush cleaner. Use the mineral spirits in that or the Gamsol in that. I use these Robert Simmons cheap brushes, and this is a messed up old Prado brush that I use as well. I just use cheap synthetics so that I don't care if they get ruined over time. You'll need plenty of rags to wipe off the brush, and then also this hand soap's really handy to clean the brush afterwards. The process is simple. I like Moleskine sketchbooks just in the binding. The paper's not terribly good, but I just lay them open flat and then apply gesso to them. Just one layer usually for the sketchbook. And I'll usually just fill the pages and let them dry and work on them as I go. So let's get started. When I use gloves just because it's nice to keep it off your hands and your clothes. I start out like I start out all of my gouache sketches by putting down a yellow wash. You could do a gray wash or a warm wash or a cool wash, but I put it down with a lot of Liquin or medium, and then I wipe off all the excess so there's just a little bit of a layer left, just the kind of stain. And that's handy because this is what I wanted to show first. Is as I got started here, I realized it was smaller than I wanted to be, so I wanted to leave this part in because of the mistake. I wanted to show how easy it is to erase your mistake and start all over again. So you just take your rag and with a quick wipe you can go back to the blank page and get started all over again. I'm trying to get in a decent contour drawing, but my main concern is the value of the image that I'm putting down. I don't really go nuts with the value sketch, but I try to get in with yellow ochre and then some burnt sienna for a slightly darker note, a good idea of the values that I'm trying to put down, and then I can build the color layers with thicker paint on top. I noticed that this skull has a particularly cool note towards the top, so I'm starting out my layers on this one by putting in some blues in this area because by the end of the sketch, I just want there to be some notes of that color. If you watch my other videos, then you might notice a similarity in the way I apply paint with oil paint and the way I apply paint with gouache, and that I pretty much use the same technique. And I sort of discovered gouache through oil. I had got a gouache set to try because I had been using watercolor for some time, and I just failed. And I tried too big, too fast, and it was just a real mess, and I couldn't seem to get my mind wrapped around the difference between watercolor and gouache. So I took a break from gouache after so many failed sketches with it, and I thought I would try oil for a little bit, which I was also terrible with. And I started messing around with oil paint, and it kind of opened up gouache for me because it forced me to rethink the way I was applying paint, because you can't really handle it the same way and you can't layer things like you would with watercolor. So it kind of forced me to rethink the way I apply paint and the way I handle paint, and also the way I see an object and the way I translate the way I see an object, if that makes sense. So right now I'm trying to get a lot of the warmer notes. There's a whole lot of light that's both bouncing up into the object and passing through the object, especially in the thinner areas of the bone. There's a kind of translucentness to the ends of it that catch light. Light gets caught up in there and bounces around, so you get some really strong yellow ochre notes. I always recommend that students try different medium, to experiment with different medium. It forces you to completely reevaluate the way you see an object. For example, I'm trying right now to tile in color in a way that I can't necessarily do with watercolor, or you could, I guess, in a sense. But I'm treating it differently than I would watercolor. And it's forcing me to rethink it, but it's also teaching me those lessons that I could bring back to the other mediums that I use and think about them differently. One of the things that kind of cracked that open for me was using a sketchbook. When I started to learn oil, and when I started to learn gouache, and when I started to learn watercolor, even though I did it each time, you'd think I would have learned, but I never really learned from the mistake of going way too big too fast. So for oil, I always thought, well, you have to learn how to stretch canvas, and you have to learn how to, you know, build stuff and learn all the different chemicals, and like, you know, there's like 900 that you can apply to oil on the shelf, and well, surely you have to know all of those to get started, and surely you have to know the exact process, or what are the ways that the old masters used to use. You have to learn their ways first. And I did the same thing with watercolor and with gouache, which was I would, you know, go with a really big canvas and learn how to stretch the big canvas and feel like I had to make this, everything had to be like this finished, perfect picture. But I never really learned how to use any of these mediums until I started just putting in the hours, just kind of clocking in with it in a sketchbook, doing simple things, and like scales on a piano, just putting in the time to learn the material and learn to manipulate how to push the stuff around. I've said it in other videos, and working in a sketchbook, especially if you're working on a material that's not necessarily the common material you would use with a medium, it forces you to just get over the fact that you're working in that medium, and you can sort of open up a little more to experimentation. Because one of the things that keeps you from moving forward a lot of times, and I talk about this all the time in my videos, is just getting attached to an individual drawing, like really wanting a specific drawing to be perfect and to look perfect. And in my opinion, you can't really ascertain a great looking picture if you are too worried about how it's going to look. There has to be a certain bravado, a certain abandon, a certain recklessness to the way that you apply paint to really pull off capturing a moment in light and in time. So again, like other gouache videos, I'm using the background to negative draw and adjust the drawing in the initial thing I'm trying to sketch. So I have a dark background. I'm trying to kind of experiment with pitching it sort of purpley because there's so much yellow happening. I thought I could maybe get a bit of a compliment going there and have a kind of purple distant background with purple and burnt sienna kind of together, and then warm that up as it gets closer to the light source. Experimenting with your sketchbooks also kind of teaches you what appeals to you in art. You know, when you study masterworks and you study people that you really like, and then you apply paint, you start to sort of see what kind of thing stands out to you. I think a lot of times you see oil painting where it's been very rendered because you could sit and noodle away, and it doesn't dry very fast, so you could sort of sit and noodle away at the color and get this very, you know, photorealistic perfect blend of the things. But I realized in practice that I don't particularly care for that. I like a big chunky fat, you know, areas of color. That's what really appeals to me with both gouache and oil. One of the problems that I'm going to have to deal with in a minute is that I have too many hard edges already from adjusting the drawing. So at a certain point, I need to figure out what exactly is this picture about, and then focus some energy in that direction. And then the things that are not important in this sketch, I need to let those things kind of fall away. So one way to do that is to control your edges. So people are attracted to things that have the highest level of contrast, and that can be contrast of edges. So your sharpest edges should be focused around the object that is, you want to be the most interesting object in the image, where you want to draw attention to. And then everything else you can kind of let fade away or get sort of, you know, looser as it goes. One thing that was a struggle when I was trying to record this was just I forgot how glossy oil paint can be. So as I was going and the page was getting covered, it became harder to film it. I had to try to change the lights and change the camera angle so that you could actually see what was going on. So here I am dealing with the edges, and I'm doing that by finding the places that I don't want to draw attention to, and then using the brush to kind of nudge and blend just to knock it off harsh, if that makes sense. Around this time, I could probably stop at any moment. I'm just sort of noodling away and trying to find those little movements in the bone and the way it curves around on the inside, just to try to catch different notes of light. And with oil, it's easier to either start with putting in some lights with fresh white or to end by putting out a separate white, because one of the harder things to get with oil is like a fresh white, because the piles, the puddles, they all sort of get muddled as you go. So working in a sketchbook, I recommend you use Liquin medium because it makes it dry. If you do not use a fast drying medium, oil paint takes forever to dry. That's one of the pros and cons. So you could just keep working on it if you wanted to, or reapplying oil and just keep it fresh and keep going and keep working. But because it's a sketchbook, I want it to dry fast so I can turn the page. If you have a keen eye, you might notice I have a puddle of Liquin off to the right and I totally forgot to use it. So I got going into this sketch and I didn't mix it into the paint or the mixtures. So this was all fresh oil right off the tube. And it is currently still sitting on the shelf drying, so I kind of made a mistake in that regard, and there's not really anything I can do now but leave it out to dry for a while. So now I'm adjusting the value where I see fit, closing one eye and squinting at the object so that I can simplify it and see where my darkest arcs are, and pop those in to get more of a read. I focused on the big areas first and then subdivided into the smaller shapes. And you could continue doing that. I could continue doing that until I have almost a photograph of the skull, but I'm not really interested in that as much as I am finding these color notes and then turning the page and finding something else to sketch. I'm trying to bring back in some of the harder highlights by using as fresh of a white as I possibly can. So that's going to be it for this demonstration. I hope you found something informative or maybe inspirational out of this one. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section or track me down on social media, of course. I would love to hear about your experimentation with other mediums. And I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching!